So today we'll be performing a first experiment. Your aim is to determine the resistance per centimeter. Resistance per centimeter of a given wire. The wire will be provided to you by plotting a graph of potential difference versus current. We will be using voltmeter, ammeter, batteries, rheostat, and we will perform this experiment. Now we have this circuit diagram. Okay. So circuit diagram properly. Okay. This will be a circuit diagram. Battery will be connected to the ammeter. That will be connected to a resistance wire. Okay. Across the resistance wire, there will be voltmeter, and the whole circuit will be connected to the rheostat and then back to the battery. Okay. So this is the battery. A wire to the battery is connected to the milliammeter. We have taken a milliammeter of range 250 milliampere. From that, the wire is connected to the given wire. This is the given wire of which we need to, across which we need to find the potential difference. So we'll be using the voltmeter across the wire. Keep in mind that the positive terminal from the battery is being indirectly connected to the positive terminal of the voltmeter. Okay, so further connections, the negative terminal towards the resistance through the rheostat. And rheostat, always keep in mind, one end doesn't matter if this should be positive or negative, because resistance has no terminals, neither negative nor positive. You just have to keep in mind that one point has to be connected towards the end and other towards the other end. Okay, and then you have to complete the circuit. Now, as soon as we on the battery, we give the power source, and some of the voltage and current is already running towards the circuit. Now this is the rheostat. As the current is coming from this side, this point will be the point of zero resistance or the minimum resistance. Now as soon as you'll observe, as soon as I'll increase the resistance, the readings in the voltmeter and the ammeter will change. Now see, initially it was this. Now as we change, it is changing. So just keep in mind for now that we have a reading that is okay. First of all, I'll teach you how to read. So zoom over here. Okay, see, the range is 250 milliampere, 0 to 250 milliampere. Now you need to find the least count. Now what is the least count? Basically, least count is the reading shown by just one single division. Now if you move C0, 0 ke baad sirf ek division wala, pehla division kitna count dikhayega, kitna reading dikhayega, that is its least count. So we can easily find it out. See, 0 ke baad first reading is 50. Now between 0 and 50 there are 10 divisions. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 the big one, and then back to 10, and that is 50. Okay, 0 to 50, in between 10 divisions are there. So you need to divide 50 divided by 10, that is 5. So least count for this will be 5 milliampere. 50 divided by 10, that is 5 milliampere. Now in voltmeter, same procedure. The first reading is 0.5, okay, and in between there are 10 divisions, so its least count will be 0.05, 0.5 divided by 10, 0.05 volt. So as soon as we change it, we have one reading. See that this is 1 volt and this is around 50, 100, so that will be 75. So that is 75 milliampere. This is, can be our first reading. Second, if we go towards 1.25, as it's in the middle, 1.5, it will be 1.25, and this is 100, around 100. This is the second reading, and slowly, slowly, you have to take few more readings. Okay. Before moving towards the observation table, first keep in mind, in each of the every experiment we'll be performing, you need to write all these things. Aim, apparatus, circuit diagram, theory, observation table, calculation and result, and then at last precautions. Before moving towards the observation and observation table, we'll see ranges of the instrument, that is in observation and calculation. Range of ammeter. Range of ammeter means how much this ammeter can show you the reading, how much it can calculate. Okay, so it is from 0 to 250, that is 250 milliampere. For voltmeter, it is 0 to 3 volt, that is its range is up to 3 volts. Least counts of ammeter scale. What will be the least count of ammeter scale? I already showed you. That is 50, 50 divided by 10, and that is in milliampere. So it will be 5 milliampere. 5 milliampere. And in case of voltmeter,
it is 0.5 divided by 10 divisions, so it will be 0.05 volt. For zero error, we don't have any zero error in neither of the other instruments, so we won't be calculating this part.
In your journal, you will see there are two more columns in the observation table. Then those are for corrected currents and voltmeter readings, but we don't have a corrected option, so just draw it like this. So in our reading, we took 10 readings according to this. Pause this video and write complete all this thing. Okay, so after performing, these are the observations that we got. Okay, you have to take 10 readings so that you can get a good graph. Our resistance came out to be around, the concurrent reading is 12.5. Actually, you have to take the average. We can easily find out our average would be around 12.5 only. So our resistance for this particular experiment of the given wire is 12.5 ohm. Now you need to plot a graph in your journal. You have to plot a graph and stick to your journal.
Your graph should look like this. Okay, there might be one or two points which won't be in the straight line, but that's fine, completely fine. Okay, so this was not our main aim to draw the graph. Our main aim was to find the resistance per given centimeter, or resistance per centimeter of a given wire. Our resistance came out by the experiment, that was 12.5 ohm. Now we need to find the length also, R by L. Now how will we find the length? We need to take a free thread. Okay, now this is our wire. Okay. You need to stick your finger to a point, just go like that, again, and again, so you need to take this point and mark it on a meter bridge or a big scale. So this wire is around 87 centimeter.
So for the calculation part, you need to, I'm just showing you, have to write accordingly to the book. Okay. So our resistance was 12.5 ohm. Our length came out, the length of the wire came out to be 87 centimeter. Now resistance per given centimeter, R by L will be 12.5 divided by 87. Now this will be 0.143 ohm per centimeter. So this was your first experiment. You have to complete each and everything as I told you. Draw the graph properly, stick it on the page, and draw the circuit diagram on the left side, blank page. Okay?